morning and welcome to today's International Space Station update. On board the crew of Expedition 30, very hard at work at some experiment and maintenance work today. That crew is comprised of NASA astronaut and Expedition 30 commander Dan Burbank, there in the center of your screen. He is on his third space flight, and he is joined by Russian cosmonaut Anton Shkaplerov, there on the left, and Anatoly Ivanishin on the right, both on their first space flights. Crew started their day at about midnight central time today before doing their traditional daily planning conference. Here you can see Commander Burbank working on what has taken up the vast majority of his work schedule. He's doing some work on the combustion integrated rack, namely doing some maintenance work and replacement on the multi-user droplet combustion apparatus chamber. This combustion integrated rack houses a number of hardware pieces capable of performing these combustion experiments in the unique microgravity environment onboard the station. Other than that, he'll get in his 2 hours of exercise, which each astronaut is required to perform each day, and also do some portable computer system laptop connections. His colleague Anton Shkaplerov started his day ending a 24-hour EKG Holter monitoring, which helps to study the heart's functions as the crew member goes through his long-duration spaceflight. The rest of his morning was taken up doing some setup and activation work on a space-to-space radio and antenna switching controller in the International Space Station's service module, also known as VESDA, which is over in the Russian segment. The latter half of his day was taken up mostly with replacing a number of light units in the Zarya module, also known as the Functional Cargo Block, or by its Russian acronym, the FGB. He will also get in his 2 hours of exercise today on both the Tevis, which is one of the treadmills onboard the station, and the ARED device. Rounding out the crew, Anatoly Ivanishin started his day with some coolant maintenance and then starting his own EKG Holter monitoring setup. Again, that's monitoring the heart's systems and functioning over the long-duration spaceflights. Later, he did some troubleshooting work. One of the systems onboard the Russian segment lost some Ethernet connectivity. That's some networking. So he was troubleshooting that and trying to find a problem before moving on to some cleanup work on a gas-liquid heat exchanger, cleaning up one of the fan screens on that. Later, he'll move into some light replacement work, along with Anton Shkaplerov, replacing lights and light panel fuses, again on the Russian segment of the International Space Station, before rounding out his day with some more exercise on the ARED and Tevis device. And the crew will have their second daily planning conference at the end of the day, discussing with flight controllers around the world the day's activities and any get-ahead work that they need to do before moving on to their sleep period scheduled today at 3:30 p.m. Central Time.